etched in the minds and hearts of all Indians. India gained freedom after years of struggle against the British rule. Today, as we celebrate India's Independence Day, we feel a deep sense of pride and glory. Homage and tribute is being paid all over India to commemorate this august occasion. We, the students of the Future Foundation School, harbor a sense of pride redoubled as we celebrate the birth anniversary of Sri Aurobindo on this day as well. His name shines forth alongside the names of freedom fighters like Gandhi, Nehru, Tilak, Bhagat Singh and Sarojini Naidu. All of them fought selflessly for the freedom of our country. Freedom and independence are comprehensive concepts and mean so much more than merely political or economic independence. Freedom means liberation from all that which restricts us and binds us from being fully developed and totally evolved. In perspective of the economic inequalities still prevalent in India, the social and communal disharmony that raises its head time and again, and terrorism that raises its ugly presence at intervals, we could say that India is still at a distance from reaching the summit of true independence. In view of this, it is only befitting to recall Sri Aurobindo's speech on All India Radio, Trichinopoly. In this message that was broadcast on 14th August 1947, the seeker, the mystic, the saint, could foresee even then what we find difficult to perceive now. That though India is free, she has not achieved unity in comprehensive terms. This issue was, is, and forever will be inseparably linked to Sri Aurobindo's final dream that was a step in evolution, which would raise man to a higher and larger consciousness and begin the solution of problems which have perplexed him and vexed him since he first began to think and to dream of individual perfection and a perfect society. It is then not for us to dream and ponder, but to precipitate action, so that each of us work at our individual levels to become more alert, more conscious, more evolved beings, so that collective evolution is achieved and ultimately we can proudly proclaim an India that is truly free, liberated and evolved. Thank you.